everyone, today I am with a very important strategy to crack CSIR NET exam. This is Gayatri, welcome back to BioSchool. Today's video is about how many questions are asked in CSIR NET exam from each unit. Should I need to prepare all the 13 units to crack CSIR NET exam? Which units are higher scoring units? Don't miss the video, watch the video till the end to know more about it. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Hey everyone, welcome back to BioSchool. And today we are going to discuss about high scoring units to crack CSIR NET exam. Here is the syllabus for CSIR UGC National Eligibility Test. And it has 13 units. The first unit is molecules and their interaction relevant to biology, which is the biochemistry and metabolism. Second unit is cellular organization, that is cell biology and microbial physiology. Third unit is fundamental process, that is molecular biology. Fourth unit is cell communication and cell signaling. Fifth unit is developmental biology. Sixth unit is system physiology of plants. Seventh unit is animal physiology. Eighth unit is inheritance biology, that is genetics. 9th unit is diversity of life forms. 10th unit is ecological principles, that is ecology. 11th unit is evolution and behavior. 12th unit is applied biology, whereas the 13th unit is methods in biology. I have video on unit wise important books for CSIR NET. You will get that link in my description box. So first, looking at the syllabus, the question comes into our mind is that, should I need to prepare all these 13 units to crack CSIR NET exam? No, it's not required to go through all the 13 units to crack the CSIR NET exam. Because, you know, let's consider the part C. In the part C, there are the 75 questions. Okay, out of the 75 questions, you have to answer only 25 questions. Okay. Similarly, from part B, you will get 50 questions. Out of those 50 questions, you have to answer only 35 questions. Okay. So the next thing is that, which unit are high scoring units to crack the CSIR NET exam? Let's see. This is the chart I have prepared from 2016 December to 2018 December for each unit of CSIR NET syllabus. The first unit, which is molecules and their interaction relevant to biology, that is biochemistry and metabolism. From this unit, from the part B, you will get around question 3 to 5. Whereas from part C, you will get 4 to 6 questions. So, on an average, approximately 9 to 11 questions are asked from unit 1, that is from biochemistry and metabolism. From second unit, which is cell biology and microbial physiology, here you can see that from part B, the questions are around 2 to 5, whereas from part C, it is on an average 5 to 7 questions. So, you will get around 7 to 12 questions from cell biology units. Okay. Let's see the unit 3, that is molecular biology. In molecular biology, approximately you are going to get around 3 to 5 questions from part B, whereas 5 to 7 questions from part C. So in total, you will get around 8 to 11 questions from molecular biology. Let's consider you are not so good in biochemistry. So the question is, should you need to focus and give more time for biochemistry units? No, it's not required, because there are other units from where you can cover the questions. Okay, but thing is that you should not skip the biochemistry unit if you don't like it. You have to choose 2 to 3 chapters, okay, 2 to 3 chapters from the biochemistry unit, like from proteins and from enzymes, most of the questions are asked in CSIR NET. So you need to prepare these 3 to 4 chapters from biochemistry units. Now moves to unit 4, that is the cell communication and cell signaling. Here you will get questions from host parasite interaction, immunology, also from cell signaling and cancer biology. So this unit is mark fetching and is convenient for the students from botany, zoology background. For all the students it's more convenient, and you will get from part B around average 4 questions, whereas from part C you will get 5 to 7 questions. So 9 to 11 questions you are going to get from this unit. Okay, now comes to the unit 5, that is developmental biology. From developmental biology, in total you are going to get 10 to 12 questions. Okay, and the sixth unit is system physiology or the plant physiology. From plant physiology also you are going to get the highest number of the questions, that is around 10 to 12 questions. If you are a student from zoology background, then you may find it's a little difficult for going through all the chapters of the system physiology. If similarly, if you are a botany student, then you may find difficulty is in developmental biology. But these two units are very important because you will get direct question from these units, and highest number of questions are asked from developmental biology and system biology. These units are highly mark fetching, and you just need to prepare from only one book. Like from developmental biology, we will focus on Gilbert, and for system physiology of plants, Dathies and Jigar are the good books. So from my point of view, you should not skip these units like developmental biology, system physiology, also cell communication and cell signaling. These are high scoring units in CSIR NET exam. Okay. Now comes to seventh unit, that is animal physiology. The animal physiology, maybe the zoology student may find it easier, but it's a little bit difficult for other students. So you don't need to spend much more time in reading the system physiology of animals. It's a very lengthy topic and it will take a lot of time to cover it. So you can focus on only 3 to 4 chapters like nervous system, okay, and from the cardiovascular system, from ECG, maybe you will going to get one question from that part, and from the respiratory system, like how the oxygen and the carbon dioxide are transported, the relationships of the myoglobin and the hemoglobin curves. So you just focus on the 3 to 4 important topics to cover the system physiology of animals. Now comes to inheritance biology, that is genetics, that is the genetics. From genetics you will get 3 to 4 questions from part B, whereas from part C you will get around 6 to 7 questions. On an average you are going to get 8 to 11 questions from genetics, and genetics is very important and also the mark fetching. So this is very important, you should cover the genetics part from the CSIR NET syllabus. Okay, the ninth unit is diversity of life forms. The diversity of life forms, you will get the question from both the plant diversity as well as from the animal diversity. And you know the diversity part of either it may be the plant or it may be the animal. These are very complex and very lengthy chapters. If you are from a like a zoology background, if you will focus on the studying the diversity of the plant to crack the CSIR NET, it will consume you a lot of time. Similarly for the botany students to cover the animal diversity. So as per my suggestion, you should not do that. And from the diversity of the life forms, you also don't need to prepare much, because from your basic concepts you can answer the questions. Okay, and from this part you are going to get around 8 to 11 questions. Now comes to ecological principle. Yes, this is very important chapter. you should not skip this unit ecological principles. And from this unit you are going to get 4 to 5 questions from part B and at least six to seven questions from part C. So on an average you are going to get 9 to 14 questions from ecological principles. This is very, very important, and also the math hatching and ecological principle, you can answer the question if you have a clear concept. Okay, now comes to chapter 11. Chapter 11 is evolution and behavior. From part B you will get around 4 to 5 questions, whereas from part C on an average 6 questions. So in total you are going to get 8 to 10 questions from evolution and behavior in CSI or NET exam. And this is also the very important topic. From my point of view, you should go through the evolution and behavior in details. Okay, now the last topic, last unit is the applied biology and methods in biology. From these two units you are going to get a lot of questions. Like from part B you will get 7 questions, and part C you will get around 10 to 11 questions. So you are going to get around 17 to 18 questions from applied biology and methods in biology. But all these questions are research based or the experiment based. You may find a little hard to solve it. If you are going to do PhD, then you should have some idea about the instrumentation and the technology. But if you want to skip it for cracking CSI NET, yes, you can. Okay. So from all the unit, what do we observe? We observe that from the part C, on an average, you are getting at least 4 questions from each unit. As per my suggestion, out of 13 units, you should focus on 6 units, and you should go through all the 6 units thoroughly and solve the previous year CSIR NET exam. From my point of view, those 6 units are unit 4, which is about the cell communication and the signaling, unit 5, that is developmental biology, unit 6, plant physiology, unit 8, genetics, unit 10, ecology, unit 11, that is evolution and behavior. Okay, so if you are getting at least 4 questions from each unit, then out of the 6 units you will get around 24 questions. And part C, there are 75 questions. Out of the 75 questions, you have to answer only 25 questions. If you focus highly on the 6 units, then you will get minimum of 24 questions. But besides these 6 units, the rest 7 units, you should not skip it all. Like, you have to just go through the basic concept of rest of the 7 units so that you may be able to solve at least one question from those parts also. If you find that some of the questions from this part very hard to solve, then you can skip it from here and you can answer only at least one question from those rest of the 7 parts. Okay, so I think this will help you in cracking your CSIR NET exam with a good score. And if you find this video useful and encouraging, then don't forget to subscribe my channel and stay tuned with me to get more videos.